Hey guys, so welcome back to the channel again. Today we are going to create our virtual machine in Windows via Nginx web server for your web application projects. This will be a very important video for you, and if you do have a Microsoft student account portal, then this video is just only for you, as it help you optimal. I do have the same account and I use already some credit points. As you know that Microsoft keeps you $100 on your student portal, so I have used some. So I also give a quick tip how can you save this credit. And without wasting time, let's create our very first virtual machine. So just simply tap over virtual machine, then go to create Azure virtual machine. Here our new panel open. This is the subscription Azure for student. If you do have a student account, then it would be fine. And if not, go to just simply sign up in your Azure portal. Then if you manage to get your student email ID, or if you do have a GitHub student educational pack, then you get this portal 100% sure. So let's jump straight to the topic. Now this ask for a resource group. Resource group is nothing but your where your virtual machine storage database or public IP address will be stored. So resource group will be very helpful. So give it a meaningful name. Just name it YouTube resource. Okay, just simply okay. Now name it virtual machine. Now I think this name would be best, YouTube Linux. Okay, you can go with this image. And one quick tip, if you are worried about what to do, you can read the documentation of Linux virtual machine in Azure portal, but you can trust on this video. So just you need a keep your name. You can give this YouTube key. That would be best. Okay, and now select inbound port. I also go with HTTP, and just simply go with this. And there is a very, very important tip that Azure now automatically generate your SSH key pair, so you don't need to generate by yourself. So just if you're done with this, go and press review plus create. Okay, this not interested. Okay, and after waiting a few minutes, you get a validation successful message, validation passed. And then this is a quick overview of your virtual machine, and then go to create. Here a time required. First you need to generate a new key pair. Here a .pnm file, I guess, created automatically. Okay, yes, YouTube key. This is the name as you name your key, virtual key. Okay, now your deployment is in progress. This is required timing, so let's wait some time. So as you can check, my deployment is in progress. One thing I must mention, I think I forget about it, that the size, I go with this size. So you can go with this size also, because this is the documentation data, so there is nothing to be worried about its confirmation or its security. So there is nothing to think about or worry about. Just go with as the video shows. So let the deployment be finished. So as you can check, my deployment is complete, and it asks for me to go to resource, and yes, you have to go to resource. But your virtual machine is not yet completed. As you can check, this is your public IP address, and if you just simply go and copy paste the IP address, you did not receive your Nginx server, so you have to create that. So just go to create connect, okay, so SSH connect and SSH. Here your SSH private key path is required, so for that I need to go to my downloads folder. So this is the YouTube key.pm copy path, so here just simply paste it and you can check the path is already updated. Also you can remove the extra data. Okay, now simply copy this, copy to clipboard, yes copied, and now go to your downloads page and here git bash. If you are on Windows, go with git bash because VS Code also give you bash terminal, but git bash will easy and helpful for you, but you cannot work in CMD or Windows PowerShell. You can, but this gonna be a very helpful if you use this git bash terminal, as this is Linux command and so Linux terminal would be best for you. Then press enter. Now it asks for are you sure you want to continue connecting, yes, simply yes. Now it require time, some yes. You get connected successfully to Ubuntu 18.04 LTS. Now to connect your web server, go to the documentation and simply copy this install web server, copy and go to git bash again, paste here. And it almost done. Yes, now press enter again. And here we go. Okay. This gives you a feeling of hacker if you change the color. And you have done it, guys. So simply exit. Okay, log out. But you have connected with your web server. Just simply back from connect portal and this is your virtual machine details. Now I have copied the public IP address and paste it here and you can check welcome to Nginx web server and you have successfully created your first virtual machine web server. So this gonna be a very helpful for you if you are working with web application in future. So that's all for today. Yes, I forgot, how can you save your money from this, as you have connected this. If you are not working on this web server, your money still to be deducted. If you come after 24 hours in your same portal, you can check that your money is deducted and this gonna be a huge amount as long as you can keep this public IP address connected. So a very important quick tip, that make sure you delete this, delete after the work you have done, you make sure delete this virtual machine so that your money is saved. So delete require time, so let it be complete. So as you can check, my deleting is in progress. Here a quick tip, that you may think that I have deleted the virtual machine, but no, the resource group is not still deleted. You have to delete it manually. So after this finished, I will show you how can you delete this resource group as well. Yes, you get the message successfully deleted virtual machine YouTube Linux. So go to your home page. Here you can check, first refresh the portal. Okay, yes, virtual machine is not found, you have successfully deleted this. Okay, now go to YouTube resource and then delete resource group. You have to copy this then paste it here, and now delete. I think delete resource group is in progress. Okay, let it complete. So as you can check, my resource group is successfully deleted. Okay, let's refresh the page. Yes, resource not found. Yes, you have deleted everything. This is very important. You may think that why I create and delete immediately. This not for you, but if you have done with it, then delete. Make sure you delete it, whereas I suffer and I lost my $6 in this way. I never use any web application till now, but still I lost this credit just for I forget to delete it, or I am not aware about it, that you make sure you delete it after use. So hope this will be a very, very helpful video for you. Make sure you subscribe for me, as this gives me a very motivation, and thanks for watching. Till then, goodbye.